Okay, so I want to go through a couple of the really big conflicts. And the one that I think is really very germane to this class is the Google versus Microsoft conflict. And I want to show you how this is working, and I want to show you Google's methodical approach to unseating Microsoft. I've already talked about Android OS and its threat to the Microsoft OS, but I want to look at this in a, I want to look at this from a much more subtle perspective. And I don't know if you know this if you've known this before, but this is really what's happening. And in fact, I think you'll see in the video of the UX guy Dan from Google that he almost says this. You know, he's there with this idea, and it's not a controversial idea. Google is trying to unseat Microsoft. So I have here on this slide a picture that kind of characterizes the Microsoft operating system, right? There's this little start menu, and all the programs are nicely organized on that start menu. And then there's a thing that you might have noticed not so long ago popping up on your screen on the, here, and it's a little Google bar. Whenever you're on a Google property, like Gmail or Google Search or Google Plus, right, Google Docs, you get this little menu bar. Gee, kind of idea look familiar to you from a user interface perspective? Two different user interfaces for frankly the same thing. I got lots of applications that I could run. One's running off of Google in the cloud, right? That's Google's big thing. They're running in the cloud, meaning they're not on your they're not on your desktop. Why aren't they on their desktop? Because Microsoft's on your desktop. That's a big thing, you know? Would Google not want you to download a desktop and become a Google application? In fact, there is the Google desktop, which is the bar right above that black bar. Right, that's the Google, that's basically your Google desktop application. You download it, it becomes a Google toolbar. It runs in your browser because that's where they can be right now. But wouldn't they love that browser to just take over your whole screen and you never leave that browser and you just live inside of the Google Apps? You pretty much could. Yeah, you pretty much could live inside the Google Apps. They got most everything. And why do they got most everything? Because they've been wanting to. They've been trying to get most everything. They've been trying to get all the things that make it so that you really never have to do anything but Google. It's the Google sphere. Right, and they're in direct competition with the Microsoft operating system. What they would like you to do is open Windows, click on your browser, and what browser? Not Microsoft Internet Explorer, but Chrome, right, their browser. And then Chrome becomes the operating system. Chrome becomes the biggest, highest level window, right? And forget that Microsoft's behind there. You don't even ever go to Microsoft anymore. You just go to Google. Can you see the competition? Can you see how Google is really trying to get sort of, they can't get underneath Microsoft, and that's what Microsoft has. That's their competitive advantage. Right now, at least, every computer, Microsoft's at the bottom, so run Google all you want. You're already paid for Microsoft, right? But Microsoft knows that how long are you going to continue paying for Microsoft if you never use it, if all you ever use is Google, and that's Google's strategy. Google's got a lot of cool things that Microsoft doesn't have. Google doesn't charge for anything because it's all advertising-based. Have you ever seen an advertisement come up in Microsoft Windows? That ain't their model. Their model is selling product. Their model is selling bits, right? And they're certainly doing all they can to try and become a cloud company and compete with Google on an equal basis. And, you know, I wouldn't be surprised if they start introducing ad revenue into their model just because they're, you know, they're scrambling to keep up with Google or whatever. But here's the competition, Google versus Microsoft. Who will be your operating system? Google's trying really hard to be that operating system, and Microsoft's trying really hard to stay in front. And both of them have the get under it strategy. Google wants to get under your entire web experience. And by the way, once they're under your entire web experience, get under your entire computer experience. Microsoft is already under your entire computer experience, and they've been beat up a lot for trying to be monopoly, right? That's what really toppled Microsoft from their high horse not so many years ago, was all the lawsuits that they were a monopoly, that they shipped with their own browser and they didn't ship with other people's browsers. Google, for some reason, is not slapped with a bunch of lawsuits. But you better believe if they ever actually took over for Microsoft, they'd get the same stuff. People would start to revolt against Google the same way they revolted against Microsoft. And in fact, they already are. All right, that's Google versus Microsoft. I love that one.